Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to the channel. Now, in this series, I will show you how you can add anonymous login with Firebase to your apps. So without further ado, let's jump right into it. Okay, so we are going to add anonymous login to our apps with Firebase, and this is pretty simple, so it will take only two videos. In the first one, we are going to create our Xcode project and set up our project in the Firebase console. So let's just do that. So let's open up Xcode here and let's create a new project, and it will be a single view app, and let's see, and I will choose next here, and I will drop it onto my folder somewhere here. Let's see, code. And I will create a Git repository on my Mac because you will be able to take a look at it on my GitHub repo. Okay, and that is basically it for here. Let me just grab our bundle identifier. And I will open up our browser and navigate to the Firebase console. Now we are going to create a new project. So select Add Project here. I will name this appropriately. So that is it. And I accept the terms. Let's create our project. Now, this will be a simple project and we will not enable anything from Firestore or anything like that. We are just going to sign in anonymously. Okay, let's hit continue here. And to enable authentication, well, first of all, let's create our iOS project because I do have my bundle ID in the clipboard. So let's hit Command V there and register app. Let's just wait for that. Okay, let's click on next. And now we need to install Firebase Core, but I do know that I want to have Firebase Auth. So what we need to do is go ahead and go to our root folder of our project, open up terminal, type in CD and a space and drag and drop it here. Okay, and hit return. And type in pod init to initialize the project, the pod file, sorry. And now I'm just going to drag and drop it onto the Xcode icon and it will open up like so. And let's set the platform to be iOS 12. And let's import here some pods. First of all, I will import tiny constraints. That is because I want to have these buttons aligned real easily. Okay, next up, we need to import Firebase. And I believe it's Auth, if I'm correct. So let's try to install all of these. Okay, let's go back to our terminal here and type in pod install. Okay, and it's downloading all of the necessary dependencies. And of course, because now we need to close this because we need to open up our Xcode workspace. There we go. So let's do that from now on. And I believe we are ready with the setup. Let me just resize this real quick. Okay, let's go back to our browser. So we do have installed all the necessary files. Now we need to import Firebase and configure it. Okay, let's go up to our Xcode project and let's select app delegate. Let's import our, let's see, Firebase Auth or core here, sorry, because we need to configure it. So after in the did finish launching with options, we want to now type in Firebase app.configure. There we go. And that is basically it. Let me just make this a little easier for you to read. Okay, let's click on next and let's skip this step. Okay, that is it for the iOS setup. Let's go to authentication and set up a sign-in method. Because if you scroll down, we want to enable anonymous sign-in. And let's just click on enable here. And of course, you need to save that in there. Okay. And that is basically it. When we do have an anonymous sign-in, we will see that under the users tab. So now let's set up our basic UI, and in the next one I will talk about the code that needs to be added in there. So let's go to our root view controller. Let's create two buttons. So the first one will be a login button, so lazy var login button. Go, it will be a UI button. Okay, here we go. Let button equals UI button, and let's return this button now. Okay, let's initialize it, and now we want to set up our views, so let's create a function called setup views, and it will be a file private function down here. So file private func, there we go, setup views. And here let's just for now set the views background color to be white equals white. There we go. And now let's go back to our button and customize it a little bit more. So button, let's say set title, and I will set this log in anon, and it will be a control state of normal. Okay, again button set title color, because this will be a white color and I want to see it on the white background, so I will set this to black. And again the state is normal, and maybe set the button, I believe that is okay. And now we need to set the button target. So add target self action hash selector, not free, hash selector. And it will be objective C method. And let's see, login button tabbed will be its name. And for touch up inside, there we go. Now let's create this login button tabbed down here. It will be again an Objective-C function, because it's a selector. So add Objective-C, and it will be a file private function, so we don't get access to it outside of our file. Okay, now let's print out here login tabbed. And let's just duplicate this, okay? And I will just rename this log out button and log out for the title, log out, there we go. And log out button tabbed, and copy and paste it in there. And finally let's add this print statement of logout tab. Now we need to set up our views even more. We want to add these two buttons to the view. So view add subview login button and view dot add subview logout button. Logout button, there we go. Okay. Now let's constrain these, let's see, login button edges. I believe I need to import tiny constraints because I haven't already done so. So tiny constraints, there we go. And now I have here available edges to superview excluding dot button and no insets using safe area. Yeah, let's use safe area here. True. And login button dot height, let's say make it 50. Okay, next up is our logout button. Logout button top to constrainable, top to bottom of constrainable, and that is the login button offset, let's say 12, and all of the others are unnecessary. Okay, logout button left to constrainable, and that is, or rather that let's constrain it to our super view. So left to super view without an anchor, and the offset should be 12 and using safe area. So let's set that to true. There we go. And let's set this to the right as well. Okay, right. What we need to remember is set this to minus. And finally, logout button dot height should be again 50. Now let's build and run and see if this is okay. And if it is, then we are finished with this setup. Okay, let's just wait for that. I will choose iPhone XR, not my phone, so we can see the simulator. And if you are wondering how this cool theme got into my Xcode, then you can take a look at my other previous episodes of how to theme Xcode to be this atomic one dark theme. And of course, this no such module is going to go away, and it already did. And while it is launching, go ahead and take a look at that. And of course, you can theme the terminal too with this cool theme too. And go ahead and do that, because in the next videos, this will be my theme. Okay, for some reason, we need to import the Google service.info plist file. So finally, let's do that. I forgot that. So let's go to the project settings and download the Google service info plist file, because without that, Firebase will not start up on our project. So let's just drag and drop it into there. And as you can see, I have already downloaded a ton of info plist files. So you just need to delete that 10 there. So let's build and run again one last time, and hopefully we will get those two buttons and some logs down here. Okay, login anonymously, login tapped. Just show you there it is. And finally, log out tapped. Okay, that is it. Now in the next video, we are going to implement all of the easy functions that we need to log in anonymously, and then of course log out. So if you did like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.